We don't know yet. No, we haven't got a script yet.
We haven't got a... Don and I haven't got a script yet.
We haven't got a script yet either.
For Disc and Music Echo, this is Tom Lodge bringing you Sound of the Stars. All right, now it's time to kick off with the one and only Scylla. Oh, hey, what on earth? What's happening?
Gentlemen.
What's going on? Oh, it's the Beatles, yes.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the recording studios. Conditions in here today aren't what we'd hoped, but we're certainly going to have a bash at producing another Smasheroo Christmas record.
Oh, wait a minute. It's not a Christmas record. No, like I said, it's Sound of the Stars. Your turn comes later on, but right now I'm trying to introduce Scylla Black talking to the bachelors.
Well, Scylla, it's very nice of you to join us this year in Blackpool.
Oh,
and,
well.
What do you think about the show?
What do I think about the show? I'm looking forward to it because, you know, after your management practically begging on their hands and knees for me, I thought,
you're the last one that needed it.
Anyway, I'm buying a new car, so...
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
What sort of car?
A mini, but it's sort of made up to look like a Rolls. They call it mini Rolls, so I should have it by July.
But I'm afraid to drive because I had a nasty accident a couple of weeks ago.
Oh, Declan, what happened to you?
I was going along the road and that's the last I remember.
I know,
it was all right. Only my head. See, there was a little part in my head.
Yes, I also noticed a few grey hairs there.
It's the worry, Scylla.
Yeah.
See, you worry me.
Oh, don't be like
that.
I get all embarrassed.
Yeah,
you did that before on us.
When?
When we had I Believe, we were number two.
Yes.
And we were all set and all the predictions, you know, for number
one. Oh, no.
And then Scylla creeps
what
up
was the
on
number
us
had
the horse and cart song.
Would it be You're My World? Horse and cart? Anyone had a heart?
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. Oh, I'll smash your faces in.
There we had the actual voices of Scylla Black and the Bachelors. But wait for it. It's Cliff Richard talking to Hank Marvin and Bruce Welch of The Shadows.
Hey, is that a new song?
That sounds alright.
What, for the film?
Yes.
Oh, that sounds great, yeah.
Do you like the lyrics?
Tremendous.
I'm glad.
I tell you, I think it's got real heart.
It has.
So we finished four.
You finished four, I think.
Great. There's the one where the women are washing at the side of the river.
Yes, I fancy that, yes.
Wash your woman.
Wash your woman.
Wash your woman.
I've got it. Look at that.
It's great.
Another lot of great lyrics as well, I thought. Very, very good.
What was the bit we had
there? It unfolds into a story of pathos and tragedy.
Listen.
Yes.
Then there's the one where you're walking with a girl in the square. Amelia.
Amelia.
Oh, this is very
Amelia.
Touching.
I just met a girl named Amelia.
You know the close of the film where the fireworks are going?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
We thought, it's a fiesta thing, isn't it?
It is, very much so.
I thought we'd probably nick the Tijuana Brass kind of sound.
Oh, great. If we start shooting next week, don't
it's May already. The rain in Spain lies
mainly
in the Pinewood Studios.
I hope it doesn't, folks.
First of all, Judy, do you ever miss Australia, living here and being away from it?
Sometimes I do, if I want to get out in the sunshine, but on the whole, I think there's so much to keep you occupied indoors, particularly in England, that I don't miss it on the whole. Oh, well, you know. Oh, I shouldn't have said that. No, but, you know, it's sort of entertainment, entertainment-wise, and, you know, everything's designed to keep you entertained, television and, you know, dancing and things like that. So I don't really miss sunshine unless I madly want to play a sport or something.
Obviously, you know, people must ask you this. Being a girl with three men in a group, how do you feel about it?
Well, it's very nice. I think, in a way, when I was young, I always wanted to have a big brother or something.
You've got three.
And now I've got three. Yeah.
Penny Valentine with Judith Durham of The Seekers. The Ready, Steady, Go Girl. Kathy McGowan sure digs the Hollies.
What do you think about people who knock your... records about people who go on jukebox jury and they have a go
at. Tell them to have a look at our bank account.
Jukebox jury don't pick the
right. You don't.
Jukebox jury don't pick the right people to go on there because you get people like you get
you've
a caterer and you get a cooker, you know. And
what?
All right, people who cooks, you know.
Really?
Simon Freud, whatever his name. What's his name? Freud.
Clement Freud Egg.
Clement Freud.
Listen,
what about last week's jukebox jury?
It's supposed to take the record for the top 20, and they don't know nothing about.
What about last week's jukebox jury? Somebody didn't know who the animals were.
Yeah. Yeah, how ridiculous.
What do you think about the fans who go screaming after you?
Great, fabulous.
I mean, you know, they must annoy you.
They've all gone over to Walker Brothers. Everybody says, oh, the Hollies will do it, and do nice for us.
You've had more hit records, haven't you, than anyone, really?
Yeah,
Turnover Time on Sound of the Stars, Side 2, includes, among others, the fabulous Beatles. Welcome back to part two of Sound of the Stars, brought to you by Disc and Music Echo, and introduced by yours truly, Tom Lodge. And to kick off the second half, two 1966 chart toppers, Dusty Springfield and Spencer Davis.
Like I was just saying about Jackie Edwards, he sort of suddenly came to the fore as a songwriter. I got an old record of his. And then he suddenly appears writing your two big ones.
Yeah, that's a fact. Yeah. He's also written Wayne Fontana's Come On Home.
Yeah?
Yeah, Wayne's done a very good job on it as well.
You know the one before, somebody help me.
Keep On Running.
Yeah, did he do it? Keep on running.
Yeah, oh
did
yeah.
Did he write it like that?
The demo disc we had, in fact.
Keep on hiding.
Was just a piano and himself.
Or did he do that beat?
This backbeat thing, you mean?
Did he do the backbeat?
Yes,
beat
oh, just like that,
isn't
yeah.
that funny?
You've been to the States, you know, all the fellas in the band and myself especially, you know, we're really looking forward to going.
Seems to be a pilgrimage for everyone to go to the Apollo, which it's all right going to the Apollo if there's somebody good on, but there's little point in it.
If there's no one on there?
No, I've been a couple of times when it was good, you know, Joe Tex was on. Who really impressed me. But otherwise, you know, particularly in California, I don't think the music isn't as good as it is here.
That was Dusty Springfield talking to leader Spencer Davis. Oh, what a meeting. The Walker Brothers, John and Gary, Pete Townsend of The Who, and Penny Valentine.
What do you think of your fans, Pete?
Well, you know, I mean, there's all sorts of fans, you know. The kind that we like the best are the ones that sort of give good reactions, you know, if we like to be... We like to be screamed at.
What about who, John?
No, fans are nice, you know. It just depends. See, we have a different problem than they have. I mean, besides, you know, reactions and things like that. You see, mums and dads come to see us, you know.
Yes, but can they hear above the screaming?
Well, that's just it. They can't. So they walk out of the theater hating us, saying, they say, oh, those Walker brothers, all they're a bunch of morons, you know.
How do you feel about sort of people that pull you off stage and things, Gary?
Oh, yeah, it's great. Actually, it's kind of expensive, though.
Does money mean an awful lot to you, Gary?
To me? Mm. Oh, yeah, I think it's great, yeah.
Money invests itself. I mean, if you write songs, for example, you don't get the money for sort of 10 years.
No.
So, you know, it's a kind of an investment, you know.
Where are you going in the summer, Sand?
Where am I going? Oh, all over the continent, Munich, Rome, France.
Oh, you are Flash.
Oh, Flash,
I'm going
Harry,
to Blackpool.
That's
me. I've been in Blackpool for 3 months.
Oh, lovely. Shall you send me a card?
Yeah, I'll send you a card from
oh,
Blackpool
thank you.
And bring
That's
some
very
rock
nice.
Back.
Sent one to Munich or something.
Have you never been to Rome before, have you?
No.
Oh, it's fabulous.
We passed through there Christmas.
Look, I'll tell you what you can do if you go there. You can get me a shirt.
What kind?
An evening shirt. I'll give you the name of it and everything. Yeah, very flowery in the front and all the
should get them from
ruffles.
Paris.
Well, it's just that I happened to see one when we were in Rome before.
Yeah, it's going to still be there in the same window.
No, I bought one there.
Oh,
so
you
can
bought
go
one there?
Get me one at the same shop.
Times sure change, for that was Adam Faith speaking to his discovery, Sandy Shaw. Oh, yes, sirree. She's the most photogenic girl in show business. This was the time I came face to face with the one and only, yes, wait for it, the Beatles!
Well, it's nice to be in the actual captain's kitchen, and the captain himself is stirring up a right old brew.
Is it true that Paul and John, that you have ghostwriters write your songs for you?
Oh, yeah.
Ghostwriters. Ghostwriters. All your songs.
We've got Gershwin and Trotsky. They write the first four.
And Lenin and Blavatsky writing the lyrics.
Yeah.
The two of the best-selling lyric writers in the country.
We just do the PR for the boys, you know.
Yeah, we just do appearances and our mop tops, you know.
Yeah. It's a hard life, isn't it?
Yeah, well, it's very hard, but just to wander around. We've got doubles for most of that as well.
What's it like being a father, Ringo?
It's great.
When are you going to be a father, George?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know.
Who do you fancy for the National?
When are you going to write another book, John?
A lot of people have come up to me and said, when are you going to write another book, John? And I've said, I don't know.
Give the pop stars a fairer share of the country's wealth.
What's your attitude towards commercial radio on land?
Yes. I don't mind where it comes from, you know, as long as it's there.
Yes, I think I'd go along with that. I think you might as well have it in the middle
get
of...
Get the local angle, you know.
Get the local news.
Local angle. You'd like to see local commercial stations?
I would like to see them. I'd just like to hear them.
Thank you very much. Ringo?
Yeah, I would. You know, more stations the merrier, I always say. You've heard me say it before.
Every day. I always
think. Well, I think if the BBC can be legal on land, then so can everybody else. You know, that's how it should be. Or they either have nobody doing it, or they have everybody doing it, don't they? Hey?
That's all from Sound of the Stars, which was devised and produced by Tony Barrow. My name's Tom Lodge, and it's been a real gas introducing you to the stars. For the finest pop pictures and the strongest stories, don't you dare miss a single issue of Britain's full-color weekly Disc and Music Echo. And remember, for up-to-the-minute what's happening and latest discs, listen all the time to Radio Caroline. And in the meantime, stay cool, real cool.